Rebirth of Legend, here with another replay analysis. This time we'll be looking at a game by Frodo Baggins, who's going to be playing a Phantom Assassin. And we're just looking for general things. There wasn't any specific problem. He actually won all the games that I was able to look at quite substantially. But I'm sure there's still going to be some little laning things we'll be able to point out and look to, because it is a normal skill bracket game, which means I believe it's below 2300 MMR. Below 3,000 MMR? I don't know. I get the windows confused. I've heard like 28 or 3,000 is like the breaking point for high skill, but whatever. It's a normal skill bracket game, so it's under 3K. But I did notice you farmed really well in all the games, and you got a bunch of kills, so I'm assuming you do generally pretty well. We'll just see if we can figure out some little extra laning things to help you out. You also play this hero on a healthy amount, and I hate you for it, but story for another day. That's not very fun for you. If this guy plays properly, like, you can handle the spiderlings harassing you because you're very, because of your evasion and, like, poor man shield or whatever, but the nuke spam will fucking destroy you. So this lane you should be thinking, oh god, we're going way too fast. Play your perspective. Phantom Assassin. These are fine opening items. If you're anticipating a lot of harass, you might want to drop the, Stout Shield for like more tank. But you have gold for it. Shouldn't have that much gold. Oh, you got a bounty. Something's fishy with your gold. I don't know. I think it's the timer throwing me off. But you might want to start with like an extra set of tangos. Just because you should be anticipating a lot of harass in this lane. Like, you're a double melee against like a brood. You're going to have a shit time. So, like, something you want to look into is, I talk about in a lot of the videos, it's like learning to control creep waves using aggro tricks. There's a huge guide on it. It's about soloing mid, but the creep tricks are completely applicable in safe lanes that are contested as well, where you're going to have a difficult time. Like, you're doing pretty well here, though. You got 3 creeps so far. Like, yeah, you're doing pretty well. So, like, what you can do is, like, when you're within 500 range of the creep wave, you attack, you force attack click a hero. You don't even need to actually hit the hero. You just right click them like you're attacking them, and the creeps will automatically aggro to you. So, if you're standing by that range creep right now, that's about 500 range to those creeps. You attack him, you'll pull these creeps towards you for 2 seconds while they're aggro to you, and then they'll reset. That'll pull the creeps closer to you and line up last hits better. You can also use that if you think, like, let's say you have a double range creep thing, and they're also getting attacked by some melee creeps. You can use it to pull the creep wave to offset the amount of damage the creeps are going to be taking, and that can give you some more creeps, too. But you want to be careful about using that in a lane where you're trying to control the equilibrium, because when you pull a creep wave, they're going to take more damage. Like, you saw those aggro to you. I don't know if you did that on purpose, but they ran towards you, and while they're running, they're just taking free attacks from your heroes. So since lane's constantly pushed, I don't think you really have the opportunity to buy a Bassy, but you might want to send it from the side shop, like a Bassy and probably a Stick, because she's going to be spamming her Q pretty frequently. You might get a few charges, and the Bassy's going to give you the regen so you can keep spamming your dagger, because this lane should become contested at some point. Missed the last hit there, but not the end of the world. I know you tend to creep pretty well in this game. How long is this game? It's a short game. I took a game at random that you threw at me. I looked and they're all like dominating victories, so it didn't really matter which one we look at. Oh, look, so you are doing some aggro tricks. That's good. So, like, if you got like 40 or 50 creeps in this lane, I'd be like pretty fucking thrilled, you know? I think they should be playing more aggressive on you, but they're not, so. What are you gonna do? Like, your Earthshaker should be buying sentries and shit so you can see what's happening and maybe, like, harass them. But I don't think you have kill potential because it's not a single brood. And even if it was, it would be pretty hard. But they're, like, not even harassing you. So this is, like, really ideal for you. Because they have, like, a really aggressive lane and they want to be getting a lot from it, and they're not. And that's, like, their own fault. Because they should be actively trying to harass you a lot more. Like, you can't delay with four tangos and you used one in 5 minutes. Oh, you know, I was wondering why you didn't go there. No mana though. Like, that's the result of, like, if you had a Bassie there, you probably would have had the mana required to, like, actually jump people. Here would be maybe another kill. What is that spider doing? Eldamorana surprises her. Nice. That's good awareness right there on your part. You know, to get that kill. Like, those two kills are huge. Like, this lane, they needed to, like, keep you on edge. So far, they haven't really stopped you from creeping. Like, you got 20 at six minutes, which isn't, like, crazy good, but that's not bad by any stretch of the imagination. I also like how you're not Battlefury rushing. You should be getting, probably treads here. Treads are gonna be good because you can use it to spam this ship more by swapping. And also, if you look at their team, they're focused on bursting you down. So you have to think through things like this when you're deciding. I think you're going to opt for phase boots because I think you do it in every single game. But you want to think about stuff because if you're on the Battle Fury build, like you're doing it to like farm a lot. And you can use like Treads, Helm of Dom or whatever. Treads, Helm of Dom, Aquila or something like that to just farm the jungle before you even have a battle. Okay, you do get the Treads. I think a lot of your games had phase, which is why I thought that. But that's good. You're actually like putting thought into things because like. The Spirit Breaker and him are gonna try and like burst you down. You're a low strength gain hero, and like that's a big threat to you. So you are stopping them from doing that, which is really good. Here you can usually I'd say get the Helm of Dominator, but I think because it's a brood, you're right if you Battle Fury rush here. Cause a lot of people like you do this is a very standard opening. Maybe you get the Aquila. You should actually get the Aquila. You can't go wrong with like an Aquila on an Agi hero unless you're a Vlad's builder, obviously, like an anti-mage. But not many heroes are like that. But like just because it's a brood and you want to just keep her spiders in check, going for it should be fine. See, like she should just be creep cutting right now and forcing you to tank shit. Like that's her really screwing up this lane right now. Cause like there's no real pressure on you right now. And like you probably could get a little more crease, but I think it's just like missing some CS. Like, not the end of the world. But, like, you played a bunch of games as her. I mean, I'd say go play in solo games, but you probably figured out how to creep on her over your 600 games. So, all right, we do get the Aquila. So, like, your itemization here is, like, really spot on. It's really, really good. One thing I would point out, though, is you're getting kind of low on health. So, this might have been where you wanted to get your Ring of Health instead, and maybe gotten the Aquila later. Because now you don't have a Tango, and like let's say that engagement went bad or you got harassed a little more, you can be scared to show up in lane. With your passive, Poor Man's Shield, and a Ring of Health, you can just go jungle these side camps and you'll regen health while you're doing it. She's a really high Agi gain too, so your armor is going to increase very quickly. But you end up with enough gold for this now. All right, cool. So far everything's being done like perfectly. And you got 50 CS at 11 minutes. That's why I said 40, 50 CS, you'd be pretty happy in this lane, right? Being kind of active. Wait, is she not leveling her nuke? Okay, that's why. Well, she shouldn't have this. Shouldn't have her ult either. This is a problem. That's why you're not struggling in this lane. She should have her Spiderlings maxed at 7, and then you'd be in like kind of deep shit. Like you go 4-4 on this hero. You don't need either of these abilities early on. Getting these two maxed early on is going to create a ton of laning pressure. Oh, let's see how you died. I was busy looking at that. Because I was wondering, because I saw you take the nuke and you took barely any damage. That's rough. I'm not going to say this is wrong, but you want to be, like, careful. Because, like, let's say if someone called, like, the mid was missing or whatever, you want to be very reserved. Because you're the one position, you don't want to die, like, ever. Every time you die is, like, pretty bad. And it's going to slow your farm a lot. So we miss, like, every kill here. And then die. It's just pretty bad. Like, they're trying to go on you. So here's how you can look at situations, too. They're trying to go on you and be aggressive here. They've already been getting shit on. Like, you're trying to turn on them. But like you want to be careful about stuff like this where you're trying to frontline. Like you're not super tanky right now, and then that Lina is just gonna nuke you down. And they don't have lots of magic nukes, which you felt when the Broodling nuked you. But if you don't know where that Lina is, you have to be really careful. So that's one of those things where, like, you have a ward here. Those are Rubick Illusions. You know she's not in mid. She could be farming stacks in the woods, but she's not bottom. She's probably coming up here because people like playing really aggressive. So, but when in doubt, even if, like, yeah, she could be farming stacks, you don't have a lane ward here, which sucks. Let me point out where the lane ward should be. If you can control your supports, this lane ward's what you want. When I ask for a lane ward and someone puts a ward here, I get really annoyed because it's useless. And when they put the ward here, I freak out because that means they're blocking my hard cam. If you put a ward under this tree line, this spawn box is something like, I think it's a little above that. I think it's like that. It's like really, it's really weird. I know I've tried to, I thought it was like the tree line, but it's not. It's farther. It's something like this. It's like the spawn box. So you can block that camp if you're trying to like ward that. But yeah, so you get this ward. If you had this ward up, you wouldn't have died to that Lina either, because you would have seen her coming. But in the absence of knowledge, you just have to assume that they know where you are. It's like this ward is kind of, it's whatever. It's not horrible, but it's definitely not good, because you can get the same intel by putting it here, and it'll cover the rune. And you have your tier one tower up, so they're not going to be coming this way most likely. And this one will cover them coming here and them doing some weird route like here. But I know it's not your job to place the wards. I'm saying, like, if you have some sort of influence, you might want to like try and talk to people about it. But your support's actually buying wards, which is really nice. So at this point, you want to just be trying to. It's kind of awkward because there is a spider in your lane, so the lane should be pushing, but ideally, in most other games, you'd be able to push this wave super hard to the tower and then move to the jungle, kill one camp in the jungle, and then walk back to lane, kill the next group wave, and then kill the other camp. I have a. There's another farming video I'll probably send you. It's farming patterns on like an anti-mage, but it's applicable to any hero who could feasibly like jungle, pretty much. So, I think the video I specifically talk about Slark is completely viable on a Phantom Assassin too. So, like right now, you'd push that creep wave. You don't sit at the tower. You just go kill a camp. I think you're looking for. You actually, I think you may have. No, there's a ward in your camp. That's what it is. That's annoying. Am I wrong? I could have sworn I just saw it. I guess it was that ward I was seeing. That might block the camp actually. Iron neutral spawn boxes. I think it does block the camp. That's one of those things you can just like look up too. Okay, I'm too lazy to look this up right now. But yeah, like this is good, and then you start pushing, and like now that you've killed that tower, you can go like deeper into the woods because you don't want to commit going too far into this unless you know where everyone else is. So right now you know that's a Medusa there. You can go fuck with the Medusa. Like, there's nothing wrong with screwing with her. She's going for a Lincolns, which is okay. I mean, it's just a bat. Like, who really cares? I don't know. I guess it's worth getting a Lincolns for the bad initiation. But you can break her shit so easily. It only prevents her from getting ganked, I suppose, which is good. It's not bad. But just a Skadi for more raw tank and then four manning might be okay too. So you should try and get this pushed at least past here, maybe to here, depending on what you see. So you see a Spearbreaker charging bottom. See a Rubick in middle. We don't know where the Lina is right now. And 15 minutes. She could have a Yules. But she has 11 creeps. Does this support Lina? Brood, Spirit Breaker. It should be a. Oh no, it's a mid Rubick. Okay. Okay. So yeah, then you would have known she's never doing stack. Or she's most likely not doing stacks. Support Linas can transition and do stacks and shit to get a lot of farm, but they won't necessarily do that.
Dire's middle tower, it's gone.
Way to punish him for that tower kill. That's good. Yeah, see, this is where you should go. I think Battle Fury, probably into BKB. They have a fair amount of nukes. They have the Spider Nuke, and she gives a mischance too. They have Spirit Breaker, whose ult and his bashes are all magical damage. While you can't prevent the bashes themselves, here you could tread swap to do that strike. So you go to Agi, so you go to Int Treads, use the ability, and then go back to Agi Treads while you're killing it. It just makes it so you lose less mana. For a really, really low interior like PA, I think it's like one. It's just one. It's gonna save you a lot of mana. Like, you have these two things, but that's like a 50 mana cost. Six of those will run you through your whole mana pool. So the tread swapping will help a lot. So that's something you should probably work on. Particularly for like the mid-game farming, we're gonna be using the abilities a lot. Because you can run out of mana on this. Like, you're already almost at a half. If you get to another camp and use it, you're gonna get pretty low. But this is gonna be good. This is gonna be like a pretty decent battle for your timing. Like, you keep in mind you got all this shit first, so that will slow it down. Well, the treads should conceptually speed it up. You're not like an anti-mage, you can't get to the camps as fast, but it should allow you to jungle those camps quicker, which should give you like a comparably timed battle fury. So we're at like 5 creeps a minute. I think you could be doing more here, but I think you got off to like a slow start because of the lane, which you should have been scared of. Because the lane itself is scary, but then it turns out they were bad, so that's why you shouldn't have been scared. Because, like, you would have been able to tell when you, like, measured his nuke level what their threat is. Nice. You gotta just run from this. Like, you can't kill that spider because you don't have detection in the lane. You gonna go back in? Just throw daggers. Man, you're one lucky piece of crap. that's really good. That's something you want to do. Like, if you have a long-range ability like daggers, and you're almost dead, and someone else is going out on your team, just kind of sit back and try and throw the. Unless they have like some sort of global ability, like a Spectre or something like that, or an AA who might be firing a blast at you, you can just sit around, like, chuck your daggers. Like, Earthshaker is another example who, just because you're low HP, if you get out of a fight, you should sit there and try and throw fissures if you can, to help your team, save your team, maybe turn a fight, go back in and Echo Slam maybe. If you have a. Yeah, so that's 19 minutes for a Battle Fury Treads. That's okay. It's definitely a little slow. But you're doing well. Like, a lot of people, like, in the lower MMR games that I see, they get a Battle Fury on PA and it comes so incredibly late because they don't actually creep. They just try and get kills. Like, you got some creeps and a bunch of kills, so this is good. I think if you farmed a little efficiently, you could probably have something like maybe like 140, 150 creeps right now. Like, going into your Battle Fury. That might be a little high. We'll say like 120, 130, 140. Somewhere between 120, 150 would be possible if you had a really good lane, got all your last hits, and then were jungling pretty effectively. It might be worth carrying Dust now, since you do have the slot. Did he already use the nuke? I guess he did. Yeah, you want to be careful, because with her mischance, she's pretty survivable. Because you're gonna miss four. It's like fighting a PA, huh? How do you feel about that? Because it's giving a 40% mischance on your attacks. When you get a BKB, you can do it. Besides that, you just want to try and kill her spiders and then like not commit. Because it's gonna be hard for you to 1v1 kill her, unless she's like attacking someone. The reason you can sometimes get the kill on her is because like if you jump her and get a crit immediately without her autoing you back, then like maybe you'll do enough damage. Then you can push it over. She's got a lot of HP though, so it'd be pretty hard to do that. Alternatively, if someone else is there and she's attacking them and then you jump on her, you might actually get your hits off without a mischance getting applied. Like, you just want to try and keep her spiders in check. You don't need to, like, go crazy. I mean, I like how you did buy the dust. Like, you recognize that gave you kill potential. So this is, like, really big killing her. Like, that's really awesome. I really like that you bought that dust. Like, you're doing a lot of really good things in this game. I don't often throw out so many compliments. God, just tearing it up. Boom, 130 CS from all that. He's got like 30 creeps from killing her and most of her spiders. Like with a PA, sorry, not a PA, with a brood, you just, if you can, just keep your spiders in check. It's kind of funny looking at that. Is there spiders, right? Yeah, it is. That, no, that's not wrong per se. I'm just, my only issue is, I think the BKB is really good and will let you fight and will let you survive ganks, which I think is really important. So you have to look at a game. You can't just like go, okay, well this is the natural progression. Like you need to look at a game. Like people who go blind S and Y on a gyro, when you look at a lineup like this, you can't go S and Y on a gyro. You need the BKB to survive Lina nukes and Lina ult. Otherwise, they can focus you down and your damage gets mitigated. Because we know this is support Lina. She's not gonna have an AGS for a long time. So getting a quick BKB is like really, really good. And this game's like the same, where you're going to want to really curious to what your MMR is. I mean, this farming's not that impressive, but like you have this skill build, which is, I think it's like a, oh, that's it. Okay, never mind. I read that wrong. This guy's a fucking idiot. I thought this wasn't level. I thought Mystic Snake wasn't leveled and Split Shot was, and he was getting stats over because that's like an old build people used to do is just completely skip Mystic Snake and get stats. It's pretty funny though. But yeah, so we should be going right into the BKB right now. When you have the Battle Fury, I don't think it's worth having the creep follow you on. Your hero can clear stacks. The Dusa, to an extent, could try and contest your stacks, but like she's not gonna do it quickly enough. And if you see them trying to do that, because like they should kill your creep, or your creep should see them trying to kill your stacks, you can go do it. Like if you're getting a Helm of Dominator, you should be trying to stack for yourself and go kill like triple, quad, or five stack ancients. Because that's gonna snowball you really far ahead to your next item. So what you would do is like you'd stack it, you'd push this really far, or you'd farm the two jungle camps, push this really hard, TP to the other side of the map, and then farm the ancients, just to keep them away while you're doing it. But it shouldn't take you long to farm ancients at all, to be honest. Pia is not a hero that farms ancients slowly. As soon as she has a nuke, you know you can kill her. It's really good. It's dagger, done. PA doesn't have her ultimate, or this fucking idiot. She let people go on her. We're gonna look at this and we're gonna judge the PA. She gets into this fight. She sees all of you coming. Uses her thing. She needs to pop her ult immediately. Oh, she couldn't. Okay, never mind. She's not an idiot. She just couldn't because she got took an arrow to the face. I mean, she's an idiot for taking the arrow to the face, but can't win them all. And now you're like a really hard force for them to deal with because you're really farmed right now. And if you get the BKB, there's pretty much no way they can really kill you. No one's gonna have MKBs. The magical burst isn't gonna be enough. Like, alternatively, you make the same argument that the main reason you're getting your BKB is because they're magic burst. If you build enough HP, then it also wouldn't matter. So if you're feeling really confident, like a Scotty might be okay now too. I don't usually say that a lot, but like if you want to just like frontline for your team, you could get like a Scotty right now. I don't think finishing a Satanic is that great at this point. So like maybe you can make the argument for the Scotty would be okay. If you didn't want to get a BKB this early. But honestly, this game's over at this point. Because like they didn't apply enough pressure to you early on. You ended up getting your farm. Like that's pretty good farm. I know it's against a spider, so you can reduce like probably 40, 50, 60 creeps off of that. That's probably like a more real number. But like you fought pretty well. And sorry, you fought pretty well. Like you got a lot of kills and fights, and like that's kind of the nature of PA games. That's why like I kind of wish I saw a game you lost, or at least a game where you didn't. Every one of the games you sent me, you had like a to like 20 kills or something, and like very few deaths, which is good. Like I'm not saying like oh you shouldn't win games that hard. It's not something like that. It's just in a game like this. It's a shorter game and there's not too many mistakes you made. I'd say like work on the farming patterns, but it was against a brood. Like I can't, she's gonna have your lane pushed all the time. You can't farm the jungle as well against a hero like that. Your itemization was great. There are a lot of really good things. Yeah, so you don't struggle to kill ancient stacks. But like you could have like a four or a five stack here right now for yourself. Yeah, like right now, if you got a Scotty, like what's her damage? 450, 320, so that's like 870. 60, we'll say 870. So her own nukes in total are like 1,000 damage. If you were to get a Scotty, it would kind of mitigate her. Scotty, I think, is like 800 HP. Because it's 25% reduction too, so it's more like 750 damage. So you can get a Scotty, like a BKB or a Scotty would be totally fine. If you get a Scotty, like you 100% can't die. Like right now, just because you have the Aegis, getting like a big HP item right now would be really good. Because if they kill you once, it means they blew literally every single thing on you, and it should be very hard for them to do it. So you need to like look at games and make decisions on the fly. Like something I do with anti-mage games pretty frequently is if I hit a timing where I have a heart and an Aegis, I all in. Like we go for Arrakis immediately at that moment. And the reason is because at the rate at which anti-mage farms, tell your team to chill and take objectives, dog. Sorry, at the rate at which like anti-mage farms, and if you're really ahead and you hit that timing, combined with like, and the same could be said for you. If you hit a point where you have all your shit maxed, you have like a heart, you do get the Scotty. Man, you're a good thinker. I like you. You're the heart of a lion. I respect you. Oh, the only thing is like, she can still provide or apply the mischance to you. Boom. You're a fucking thinker. I respect that. But that's really cool. I didn't actually think you were gonna get that. I didn't look at the itemization in the game before I opened it up, so I didn't know you were gonna get the Scotty. Genuinely surprised and very happy. That's cool. Like I don't know if you thought it out to the same extent like that I explained, but I can assume like you thought about it to some extent, 'cause that's definitely a weird item to get right now, and I don't think you got it in your other games. But yeah, like if you realize like I have an Aegis, I have huge physical survivability. And like in Anti-Mage's case, he also has huge magical survivability, which makes it like a little better. But like your physical EHP is like huge. You have 62% resistance, 50% evasion, and like barring like magic damage, it's gonna be very, very difficult for them to kill you. And if you get well past their magic damage threshold, which is somewhere around like, if they focus everything on you, maybe it's like 1500. Because you have Spider Nuke, which is 225. You have his combo, which should be something like 400 damage, maybe. I think it's like 400 magical damage. His is pretty low. It's only like, what, like 280, yeah. And then hers, we said, are probably about 1,000. So we got like, after resistances are added together, it's like 750. That's, well, we can't know what he's going to steal, but we'll just say only like, we'll say 300 just for the sake of being fair to a possible spell steal. 250, so that'll put you at like 1250, and then whatever the spear breaker has to put out, and then maybe a mystic snake, but like the point is like you're still like well past that threshold. You still have 600 HP to work against their physical damage, and their physical damage is so minimal against you right now, so that's like such a well thought out item. It's like you really, well, I mean, you played 600 games in here, so I'd hope you understand the hero pretty well. So that's like really, really well thought out. Fawning over it, sorry. But yeah, like this game is pretty over. So that's some really good stuff. And you still have like pretty decent farm. But like, it's good, like, if you're in a situation like this, like, you shouldn't be trying to, like, increase your farm unless it's, like, the difference between you getting another core item or not. Oh, dunzo. Incapacitating bite, super annoying. Let's see. What are we gonna say? So, like, just do like kind of like a recap. I think you did so many things right in this game. Like, a lot of things right. I think if the lane was under more pressure, I would have been interested how you responded. But, like, you still didn't do bad or anything. Oh, I thought you were about to eat another arrow. Learning some aggro tricks. I think I saw you use them one time, but I'm not sure if that was on purpose. Tread swapping is another really big thing. When you were farming over here, I pointed out how you should be tread swapping to use this stuff. When I respond, I'll send you both like the farming tutorial video that I made, which I think is pretty quick. It's like under 20 minutes, if I remember right. And And I'll send you that Chax guide or whatever to solo mid, just because the creep aggro tricks in it are good. He explains them in depth. I mean, what I said gives you the gist of how it works, but he can give you like better written examples because I don't know if I explained it that clearly. And besides that, like everything you did was pretty good. If you want, feel free to send over another game where it's like more contested, because like everything went like really well for you, so there weren't like decision issues you really encounter. Like everything was really straightforward. There was never that situation where the enemy was in control and like split pushing, and like it's you like floundering around deciding whether you should split push, how you should approach the fight, and there was like never a situation presented like that. And PA games can be like that though, just because like when that hero snowballs, it's really hard to deal with her. Because the natural evasion, you need to like be ahead, get an MKB or do something to like chain stun and lock her down. When you're in like this situation, it is incredibly hard to deal with that hero. But I mean, it's no reason to watch the last few minutes of this game. So I won't lie, I don't think this video was too helpful. That's why I feel free to send another game over. I point out the things you did right, good itemization, good everything. At this point, doesn't fucking matter what you got. I would have been cool with an MKB or an Abyssal or a BKB. Boop. Oh, and you should have used this to stack. You should have used your creep to stack to get you further ahead. That creep kind of sucks for stacking. Usually, the troll creep is really good, or my preference is range creeps. Range creeps are really good to stack with. They've got like good animation, really long range, so the creeps don't get stuck attacking them when you're trying to stack. This one, you have to run into the creep wave, so the range creeps will sit there attacking him as he's running away, which can screw up your stack timing sometimes. But yeah, that's really it. Hope it helps out, send you the other things, and good luck in your future games. But well played, dude. You played really well this game. Only that one mistake where you didn't account for where the Lina was. And since it was a support Lina, you should anticipate that she'll probably try and show up at a lot of fights. But besides that, really well done.